Hi everyone, this is Venkat Narayana from Sunya Technologies. Today I am going to discuss minimum, maximum and some extension methods in LinQ. This is continuation to previous video, part 2, count and long count in LinQ. Please go through previous video before going to this video. We are going to discuss min, max and some extension methods using Visual Studio. Launch Visual Studio and create C# console application. Create a class fed and declare two properties, prop 2 times tab, string name, prop int is. Here we have pet class and it contains two properties, name and is. Now we need to create object for pet class and store it into array of pet. Pets equal to, here we have three anonymous objects and these objects are storing into array. Now we will use min function to find the minimum age from these anonymous objects. Pets dot min and pass selector. Here declare variable pet such that pet dot age. Here minimum function taking func of pet and returning integer. Here return type of min function is integer. So we need to declare integer variable in result. Print the output console.writeline the youngest animal is result. Here we are passing all the pets to minimum function and we are finding minimum age from those objects. Control F5. Here the youngest animal age is 1. So from these three objects, here Whiskers age is 1. So this is the youngest animal. We'll debug this program to understand flow of execution. Click F11. Here we have array. Before assigning the values into the array default value is null. Later we are storing three anonymous objects. F11. Now this array contains three anonymous objects and here we have values. Now we are passing all the pets to minimum function and finding minimum age from those objects. F11. Here first we get the first object. Here age is equal to 8, name is equal to barley. So we will get age. Later we will get second age and we will compare previous age with current age. So previous age is 8. Current age is 4. So 4 is the minimum. Later F11. Now current age is 1. So 4 comparing with 1. So here minimum age is 1. So we will get the output. Here result is equal to 1 and print the output. Here output is the youngest animal age is 1. Now check maximum function. So in the place of min, replace max. Here replace oldest in the place of youngest. Control F5. Here oldest animal age is 8. We'll debug this program. F11. Here array contains all the pets. Here we have 3 pets. So we need to find maximum age from those objects. So here age is equal to 8. Second one age is equal to 4. Third one age is equal to 1. So among these objects, here first one barley age is 8. F11. Here we got the first object and age is 8. Later age is equal to 4. Later age is equal to 1. Among these three objects age, this object age is maximum, so it will return this value. F11. Here output is 8. F11. Here output is the oldest animal age is 8. Now we'll check sum function. Replace max with sum. Here the sum of all animals age is control F5. Here the sum of all animals age is 30. Here 8 plus 4 plus 1 will get 30. We'll debug this program to understand flow of execution. F11. Here we have array with all the pets. Later we're getting 1 by 1 pet and we are adding ages using sum function. F11. First pet age is 8. Now 8 plus second one 4. 8 plus 4 12. Then third one 12 plus 1 13. So here we are getting result as 13, and we are printing the output F11. Output is the sum of all animals' age is 13. We have discussed minimum, maximum, and some extension methods in LangQ. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.